السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Last week I was trying to meet a new challenge, which is to climb a mountain in Wales called Penyffan in a place called Brecon Pickens. As a part of preparing myself to climb Kilimanjaro on the 9th of December for my 70th birthday. I have made quite a few challenges before during Ramadan and during Srebrenica massacre memorial, remembrance of Srebrenica massacre, as well as the day of Arafah. It was walking between 10 kilometers, 12 kilometers on foot. But I have not been climbing mountains since 1997, 98, when I climbed three mountains in Kashmir on the same day. So between 1997, 1998, and 2020, no climbing to any mountains. I was advised aggressively by my children, as well as by the guide or the instructor, to take a lot of water, drink a lot of water, take nuts, high energy food, to help me while climbing this mountain. The purpose of climbing the mountain is to raise funds for the blind people in Africa, especially for cataract operation, which costs about $90 for each, and actually to let them to regain their eyesight back again. And I thought, because I was walking on the first three challenges for Arafah, day of Arafah, end of Ramadan, and Srebrenica Day Memorial. Srebrenica Memorial Day is easy to fast when you climb the mountain. But many times I was advised by the instructor and also my children about the kind of clothes, the stick, two sticks, walking sticks, or the cane, and all these sort of things. But I decided not to follow the instruction of my guide and my children, and I decided to fast without telling them. This was a very stupid question that a very stupid act I have done. So soon we arrived there. I was asked by the instructor and my colleague, which about five or six, the Jangir Malik, Yusuf, Bilal, Rawad, and Muaz Saif. Every time I give the excuse, no, because I don't want to drink water or any other liquid, because I don't want to go to the toilet while climbing the mountains, I don't want to take anything. Even I was offered some dates just to give you the energy, but I refused because I was fasting, but I did not want to tell my colleagues that. Why I was doing this? Because I remember the scenes of this elderly crossing the mountains in Bosnia, or the young children being carried by their parents when they cross the mountains in Bosnia, or being carried on their backs when they're coming from Syria to Turkey and other places. I thought, why don't I stand for their cause and do as they were doing? The difference between me and them, that they were doing it, they were forced to do that. That maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was helping them more and more and more to cross these mountains and these lands, to go to the other side, give them more energy. But in my case, I had no excuse. Anyway, I struggled to climb the mountain, and it took me more than 3 hours to climb the mountains. Most of the young brothers have finished it in 2 hours, and we celebrated the climbing up to the summit. But unfortunately, on the way down, it's more difficult than on the way up. I started to feel the pain, I started to feel the fatigue, I started to feel the tremors and the switches, the twitching of my muscles, which could not be able to hold my joints, whether actually my ankle joint, my knee joint, and my hip joint, even my elbow and my wrist joints, because I lost a lot of water. I was fasting and took any food with me, so it was a very, very difficult journey to go down the bottom of the mountain. And every time my colleagues trying to give me something, I said, no, I don't want to take anything because I don't want to go to the toilet. I didn't tell them the truth, because if I told them the truth at the time, they could have been swearing at me and cursing me. Alhamdulillah, was a great struggle and help from Rawad and from Bilal. I managed, or they managed to let me to come to the base, and they went home. Even my daughter came, was cooking some food for me, and she was saying that, putting the food on the table, telling me, why you are not eating? Are you fasting? I said, no, I'm just trying to do something. I didn't know to tell her. To be very honest, I did a grave and a stupid mistake. I was like comparing myself to the donkey who has all the knowledge in the books that he's carrying on his back, but he does not understand what's inside the books. I've been advised many times not to do that, but I did it. I shouldn't have done it. I should have listened to Bilal. I should have listened to my daughters, my sons, and my wife, but I didn't. So please, 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 when you go to a challenge like this, please follow the instruction of the instructors and the people who have the experience. Don't risk your life. The people who cross the mountains, climb the mountains, cross the valleys and the borders, Allah give them more energy because they needed it. But for me, it was a test, it was a try. I was stupidly not following the instruction. When I told my colleagues at the time, everybody was shocked how stupid man I was at the age of 70. To celebrate my 70th birthday in Kilimanjaro, or failing to climb the Pinifan mountain in Brecon Beacons. Actually, this was one of the stupid mistakes that I have done in my life. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.